Hello everyone, let us now learn how to use layers. Now layers are very useful in AutoCAD because it helps us organize our drawing. It helps us control what we can see in the graphics window at any particular time. Okay, so let's explore more about layers. So under the Home tab, in the ribbon you can see the layers panel here in the middle. Okay, so as you can see here, you have layer properties, and these are different shortcuts for the functions that you can use for the layers. And this drop down right here is used for selecting the current layer. So the current layer means that it is when you draw, when you set, let's say for example, 0 as your current layer, when you draw an object, a line or anything, a rectangle, under 0, if 0 is a current layer, it will be classified under 0. Okay, so let's delete them first. Okay, so let's go to the layer properties and let's try to create some layers. Okay, so but first, this is the layer view, list view, I mean. So this contains the list of all the layers that are available in your drawing. As you can see here, you have different columns. You have here the status, and this check mark right here refers to the current layer. So if I double click this dev points right here, as you can see here, the drop down, the dev points is the one that's selected. Okay, you have your corresponding name and the on and off. So if you turn a layer off, let's demonstrate it here. So let's say if I turn the 0 off, then are the layers classified as 0 will disappear. Okay, or the objects under the layer 0 will disappear. Okay, you can no longer see them, but they're still there, but just can't see them. Okay, and for the freeze, it automatically turns the layer off also, and this is used so that you cannot modify the particular layer. And the lock, as you can see, if I press lock, if it is locked, it becomes a little bit dimmer. And if you hover your cursor on that particular any particular object on that layer, so as there will be a lock on top of the cursor, so that is an indication that this is this, you cannot modify this object. Okay, so and this plot right here is if, for example, you want to output your drawing. So if it is not enabled, let's say like this, it has a minus sign with the red background, so it will not be included in your drawing. Okay, it will not be included in the output. Let's say if you output it to a PDF, so it will not be included, but if you turn it on, then it will be included. Okay, for the color, you can change the color of your layer for this is for organization purposes also, and for I would say neatness of your drawings. Okay, so in the line type, you can select different types of lines. There are many options right here, the ISO dash, and also, okay, so many other line types to load. Okay, then you also have the line weight. We've discussed the line weight before. This is basically the thickness of your line or the weight of your line. Okay, we have transparency also, so you know what transparency means, and you can set different options for transparency from 0 to 90. Okay, so the new VP freeze is if you use different viewports, then the new VP freeze will, if you lock a particular layer here, if you freeze it, then it will not it will control the appearance of that particular layer if you create new viewports. So we will use viewports in later modules. Okay, so let's try creating our own layer here. Let's say we want dimensions to be in another layer, and let's change the color to, let's say, yellow. Okay, and then let's create another one, circles, and then let's change the color to red. Okay, now we have two new layers. Okay, very cool. Okay, so let's create some let's set dimensions to the current layer, and let's add dimensions to these drawings right here. Let's say we have dimensions. So as you can see here, the color is yellow, right? Because it is classified under the dimensions, and we call our dimensions yellow. We have 100 right there, 50, another 100. Okay, so those are the dimensions. They are a little bit small, but okay, they'll do for now. Okay, let's create some circles too. So, get some circles right here. Circle. Oh wait. So yeah. Center radius. Okay. Okay. Then CO. Move. Let's turn on the ortho. Okay, so you have two circles right there. Let's create other ones. We have here tangent, tangent, and tangent. Okay, we have 3 point. Okay, so there you have it. We have our objects in different layers. Okay, so let's explore what we can do with these layers. Okay, so you can see here, here is a shortcut for turning layers off. So let's say I want to turn off the dimensions. Okay, so if I turn this button, if I select this button and if I click on the dimensions, as you can see, it turned the dimensions off. And you can also turn all layers on. Okay, here we go. Got that. And in this isolate, whatever layer that you select for isolate, it will be the only layer that will appear in the drawing. Let's say if you want to select the dimensions again. Select dimensions. Okay. Select objects on the layer to be isolated. Okay, I already selected that. And as you can see, if I press enter, the dimensions layer is the only layer that we can see now. Right? And you can also unisolate by creating this button right here. So, all the layers appear already. Okay, so what isolate does is it turned off all the other layers. Okay, so we have freeze also. You can select our favorite example again. Let's turn up the zero layer now. Okay, so the zero layer is frozen. If you go to layer properties, as you can see here, the zero layer is frozen. Okay, and then if I thaw all layers, then there you go. You can see the zero layer again. And then lock, lock, we've demonstrated that. So you can see here, the color becomes a little bit dimmer to indicate that it is locked. Okay, so we can unlock it also. Okay, and then we have make current. Okay, let's say our current layer right now is circles. Let's say I want to make dimensions the current layer. Okay, so if I select that, dimension is now our current layer. Okay, so that is really... So, you might be wondering, why would you use this if it is easier to just choose in the drop-down? It is useful because most of the time, if you have a really big project, there will be so many layers that it will be easier to just select it on the graphics window. Okay? So there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. So those are the layer properties, and now you can control the layers. Okay, so thank you for watching. See you in the next video.